Recently, I've been buying the English language editions of the Bakano light novels, and in the afterwards to each light novel, the author would mention an aspect of a movie he likes. Of what I've read, he's mentioned Takashi Miike's Dead or Alive, David Lynch's Eraserhead, and KatsuHITO Ishii's
Body 7.
Seeing as I had already seen two out of the three, my curiosity was piqued for Party 7, and it turns out to be a very unexpected surprise. That could really be said of the whole experience of seeing the film Party 7. Party 7 is not a well-known movie, which means I won't be getting a whole ton of views on this video. Good thing I don't make these videos for the views. But despite that, Party 7 has an all-star cast. There's Yoshio Harada, who's been in movies since the 60s. Masatoshi Nagase, who went on to Suicide Club, among other things. And of course, there's Tadanobu Asano, who's most famous for voicing Fizbee in Redline. Along with them is Akemi Kobayashi, who later voiced a character in Redline. And lastly, there is Tatsuya Gashuin and Yoshinori Okada, most known for voicing Lynchman and Johnny Boy, respectively. So in all honesty, this movie might have been a premature Redline reunion. Pretty much all of the cast outside of Harada and Asano were just at the start of what would become pretty successful careers in their respected fields. Akemi Kobayashi went on to do more modeling than acting, but the rest went on to do their fair share of credits in movies. But it's no surprise to see any of these people, really, because most are KatsuHIRO Ishii's regulars. And among Ishii's regulars is a man called
directed by Takeshi Koike.
Takeshi Koike would later do animated sequences for Ishii's later films. But more importantly, Koike is the director of Redline, a movie that KatsuHIRO Ishii had a very large hand in making. Is the original concept, the characters, the writer. He's basically everything except for the director. And his collaboration with Koike goes all the way back to Party 7. Now, that opening gets you hyped. It introduces all these unique characters and really gets you going for an insanely off-the-wall Japanese wacky movie. What it doesn't get you ready for is
じじいだよ。お前じじいと結婚すんだよ。いつもダーよ、誰垂れ流してさ。歌とかこうぶら下げてんだけど、くせえから誰も近寄んねえな。近所の人からおしめさんなんて言われてさ。生意気なクソガキにおしめなんて言われてさ。おい、サッカー行こうぜ、おしめなんて言われて。うん、行く行く、僕サッカー大好きなんつって喜んで行くとさ、落とし穴にまんまと引っかかって埋められてさ、3回ぐらい死ぬんだけど、そのまんま生き返るからさ、おしめしててもなんか妙に貫禄あったりして、若い娘に人生相談も仕掛けられたりして、2年1回ぐらいポッキすんの。お前そういうじじいと結婚すんだよ。おしめが結婚相手だ。おしめなんてしてないよ。
It's the whole fucking movie. This is Party 7. This is the actual Party 7. Despite what the intro might make it seem, Party 7 is actually a movie about six people in two separate rooms until the last 10 minutes of the movie. Now I say this because it's misleading. Everything in this wonderfully animated intro sequence is a misdirection. Everything surrounding the film is misleading. This bikini shot on the poster is never in the film. Several film reviews call this a manga adaptation, despite there being no proof that there is a source material for this movie. Even the name is misleading, considering most of the focus is on six people, until the seventh member of the party shows up at the very end. Party 7 does a fantastic job setting you up for a movie that never happens. I would be more mad if it were terrible. The fact that it is not terrible simply makes it frustrating. This was only the second film from KatsuHIRO Ishii, but seeing as he went on to make some very successful comedies, it should be no surprise that the humor here generally hits its mark. But it is a very specific, very Japanese-y style of humor. The type you would find in something like Cromarty High, but it's not going to be everyone's cup of tea. Get it? But even with good comedic timing, the main plot device of this movie itself makes it frustrating. The movie begins with a former Yakuza escaping to a hotel with a suitcase full of money. As the characters are introduced, you're waiting for something to happen with the suitcase. And it never really does. Every joke has a setup and payoff, and the suitcase is no exception, but most of the movie is really just waiting for things to get crazy. And it does, in the last 10 minutes, and then it's over. Part of me wants to blame my own expectations. But really, my expectations were set up in the first 6 minutes of this movie. My expectations were for a movie that wasn't Party 7. I was expecting Killer 7. Instead, I got an episode of Seinfeld. Now, I liked Seinfeld, but when I go in for Killer 7, I don't want an episode of Seinfeld. It's this bait and switch that might just ruin a perfectly fine movie. Of course, that might not happen if you watch this video. Because now that I've spoiled that the movie isn't what it seems like from its animated intro, you might actually end up enjoying it just as a comedy. If you go in knowing that it's going to take place in one location, you might end up enjoying it more than I did. There's a certain skill to misdirection. Movies like Audition use misdirection fantastically, setting you up with a romantic comedy and then ending with a visceral horror film. Part of me feels like the expectation reversal for Party 7 was an accident. The other part of me feels like it's just a big middle finger to the audience. The movie, the actual contents of the movie, aren't bad, it's just not what you're set up for. If you watch the trailers, if you get 10 minutes into the movie, if you look at any of the posters, anything surrounding this movie, you will be set up for an entirely different film than what Party 7 has to offer. So I don't feel like it's entirely my fault for having a different expectation of what this film actually is. But at the end, that is part of the joke, is that it's not what you expect. Very few things in Party 7 are. However, this very key part to the movie might be just what keeps people from enjoying it. So now, whoever's viewed this movie and is interested enough to watch it, go ahead, watch it. You actually can find it on YouTube and rent it at a pretty low price. Here's a trade secret. Download one of those apps that just lets you fill out surveys for Google Pay money. They'll do it real easily. Build up some credit in your Google wallet. That way it's just free money. You'll get around like $3 in a month. That's fine. $3 or $4. Rent Party 7 from YouTube, because it's on there. Watch it for yourself. And then come back to this video and leave a comment. Tell me whether or not actually going in, knowing what the movie actually is, helped your experience at all. Or if you're still disappointed by the overall experience. Anyways, that's it for now. My next video won't be an Asian Oddities video, so for those of you that come here for not Asian Oddities, I guess you'll be happy. I would assume that's most of you. Not looking mad or anything. My next video will be on Bakuna, and how it is a fantastic adaptation. Till then,